News Limerick.
President McAleese has added her voice to the tributes being paid to the musician Tommy Makem, who died yesterday. Tommy Makem died in Dover, New Hampshire, following a long illness with lung cancer. He was aged 74.
A long time ago, this proud old woman did say,
it was a long time ago that the voice of Tommy Makem was first heard singing songs, and for seven decades he continued to enthrall all those who heard him. The man who became known as the modern-day Bard of Armagh mesmerised audiences not only with his magnificent baritone voice, but also his banjo, tin whistle, poetry and his stagecraft.
With me ing twing of an ing thing of a night o' dry spit. With me ing twing of an ing thing of a night it.
The son of the legendary source singer Sarah Makem, the young Tommy left home in Keady, County Armagh, for, as he sang himself, the shores of America. Both he and his longtime friend Liam Clancy had acting ambitions, but soon teamed up with Clancy's brothers Tom and Paddy.
I remember we had a mass meeting one time, the four of us, to decide whether we were going to go up with a singing lark or go back to our proper jobs in the theatre. So we decided to give this singing thing 6 months, which I would do it for a bit of cry.
But it was 1961, folk music was in, and audiences across the US couldn't get enough. Stars such as Joan Baez, Bob Dylan, and the Clancy brothers with Tommy Makem went from playing small clubs to audiences of 80 million on The Ed Sullivan Show.
Our ship is docked in New York Town, and we took our bags ashore. This was the land of the free, they said we'd see our times no more.
Makem's talent as a prolific songwriter and entertainer have brought him dozens of awards in as many countries, including last year an honorary doctorate from the University of Ulster. Despite his illness, he took time to return to where it had all begun.
And that was my grief.